Good evening. Also in tonight's programme, there are a few fishing hints, but first, today's headlines. An entire housing estate at Merstham, near Redhill, Surrey, was sealed off today after the discovery of a major gas leak. A pressure valve fault had allowed gas to force into pipes at vast pressures, bursting pipes in scores of places, lifting manhole covers and breaking tarmac road surfaces. The alarm was raised just after midday, and police and fire services quickly moved into the estate. All 3,500 homes there were being disconnected from the gas supply. A fire spokesman said the whole area could become an inferno, but residents were still ignoring no smoking signs, and they were watching the activity with cigarettes in their mouths. You could call that living dangerously, I think. An emergency centre was set up in a local church hall in case homes had to be evacuated. Well, it's been the sort of day here in London that makes popular paper sub-editors break out in a rash of headlines like, "Phew, what a scorcher," or, "Caw, it ain't our fault, Mum." Well, it really has been 66 degrees Fahrenheit. If you're modern-minded, that's about 19 degrees centigrade in London today. But the warmest early March day it has been since 1948. Just so you can gauge how hot it was today, the average minimum temperature last March was 48 degrees. And I just remind you that Monday's temperature, only 48 hours ago, was 46 degrees. Today, 66 degrees. Phew, what a scorcher. A reminder that the UEFA Cup match between Queen's Park Rangers and AEK Athens goes ahead at 7:30 tonight at Loftus Road, Shepherd's Bush, and not, repeat, not at Wembley tomorrow night. All seats are sold, but there are 15,000 ground tickets available. The Greeks, who've caused Rangers more than enough headaches already, today refused to let the London club know which hotel they were staying in, with the result that Rangers had to cancel plans to entertain the visitors socially. Be warned, by the way. If you want to get in, go early. Now, you may have seen that publication of the latest reports on Britain's housing problems, compiled by the National Economic Development Council, that report is being blocked by left-wing members of the committee. A massive market survey has revealed that 69% of the population want to own their own home, that's over two-thirds, as against 21%, that's about one in five, who would rather have council accommodation. Mr. Hugh Rossi, who is the opposition spokesman on housing, has obtained a copy of this controversial report, and he's with me tonight to give exclusively to the Today programme details of what the report says. I want to be sure of one thing, Mr. Rossi, that report's embargoed. You and I are not going to spend the night in the Tower of London.
No. Right. I'm revealing it tomorrow at 12 noon to a press conference.
Right. Now then, first of all, why do you think the report has been held up so long? Is it because some of the findings of that report conflict with the dogmas, the ideological beliefs of certain members of the committee?
I think that's right. It's an impartial report. It contains a great deal of very important data that's been very carefully researched. It's a very heavy document. There are about 185 pages full of tables, and for the average person, it really mind-wrenching to go through it. But it is important, as the chairman of the committee said in his preface to it, for anybody who's interested in housing. And it's headed, you see, a document, Housing for All at a Price the Nation Can Afford. And what this does is to knock on the head a lot of left preconceived ideas about housing.
OK, well, I'll take you up on the political implications of that in a second. I understand that the publication of the report has been delayed by the refusal or the non-acceptance, as it were, by six or seven members of a 26-member committee.
That's right.
With some of the how can six people stop a council that
way? Well, it's the way they refuse to sign the report. And they have got the practice whereby they try to produce a unanimous report. I would think it would make more sense if the majority published this report and said to the others, well, look, if you don't agree with any of the detail, put in a minority report. But for goodness sake, let the public know what they ought to know, the truth about housing in this country.
Well, let us let the public know now. What does the report say?
Well, there is an embargo on it until tomorrow.
Yeah.
But what it does show, really, what we've been saying for a long time, and as you've just mentioned, majority of people in this country, if given the opportunity, would far prefer to own their own home than to be council tenants. And moreover, it will cost the country a great deal less in economic terms, in rates and taxes, if that were brought about.
And we're breaking the embargo, I'm sure.
No, that's not. No, I'm not breaking the embargo.
Well, I don't mind
because
if you
this has been said already publicly by a number of people.
And by Harvey Elliott in the Daily Mail.
That's right. So I'm not saying anything so far that has not been said. But right, what but is important is the detail.
You did mention money, though, and in fact the subtitle of the report, At a Price the,
at a price the Nation Can Afford.
Well, you tell me how the nation could afford what this report says.
Well, now you're asking me to break the embargo. Can I refer to another document, which is not embargoed, the government white paper on public expenditure. That showed that for 30% of the population, in 1976-7, £4,000 million almost are being spent. That's in the public sector for housing. For 53% of the population who are buying their own homes, £1,000 million. So you've got a ratio of four times the cost for 30% of the population as you have for 53% of the population. Now, that was the government's own paper that was bypassed. People didn't really take much note of it. This document here has gone into the thing in far, far greater detail, taking, for example, the cost of providing a council house over a 60-year term, which is the borrowing term for a local authority, and comparing it with what it costs the country in helping an owner-occupier buy his own house on mortgage.
Now, one of the things, you see, I've done some soundings amongst those left-wing members who've been holding up the publication of the report. And one of the things they say is that they do agree that mortgage repayment costs have gone up so much compared with the rise in council houses that what they're after is a total restructuring of the nation's attitude to housing. They say they're not holding the report up for ideological reasons, but because it needs an even deeper look into the problem than that report.
Well, if they have that to say, why don't they produce their own report? I mean, this is a positive document. This is not a document that proposes a political viewpoint. It's not written by politicians. It's written by people in the housing business, builders, councils, trade unionists, solicitors, all the people who are concerned with providing housing for the people. And they've had intensive market research into the situation. And they have produced a lot of facts and figures and tables. One can draw one's conclusions from those facts, figures and tables. What I think is totally objectionable is that an attempt should be made to suppress those facts, figures, because they should be unpalatable for political reasons to a very narrow minority on this committee.
Well, this, of course, appeals to me as a journalist. Are you suggesting there is, in fact, some political censorship at work?
I suspect so. I can't see any other reason for this being suppressed at all. I believe this report has been censored, and it's been censored for the worst kind of censorship imaginable, political censorship. And that is why I have been so determined to get this document see the light of day. I've pressed the government to produce it, I've asked questions in Parliament, I've written to the Secretary of State, and I've had complete but embarrassed silence.
Well, so there won't be an embarrassed silence now, Mr. Rossi. Are you going to give me one fact that that report tells us?
I think I've indicated enough already to give you a very shrewd idea as to what that report contains.
So if we take what you have said with what has already appeared in the papers, we'll have a pretty shrewd idea of what is in that report.
Of the general conclusions, what I intend to show tomorrow are the detailed workings out in terms of statistics to support the two contentions that I have made, namely that people want to own their own homes if they possibly can. Secondly, it is far cheaper to help them to do that rather than to make the state provide everything for them.
Well, I expect that all of us, mortgage payers or council house dwellers, will be listening to you with bated breath tomorrow. Thank you, Mr. Russell.
Thank you indeed.